Uber launches women-only bike taxi service Moto Women in Bengaluru. Uber, the ride-hailing firm, rolled out Uber Moto Women in Bengaluru, offering women-only bike rides. This is the first of its kind service for Uber globally, and the company has plans to scale it up in other top cities such as Delhi, Mumbai, Kolkata, Chennai, and Hyderabad. This on-demand two-wheeler ride service connects female riders with female drivers and is designed to address women's safety and mobility needs while empowering female drivers with flexible earning opportunities. Developed based on feedback from women riders and drivers, Uber Moto Women offers a safe, affordable, and convenient commute option for women who would prefer to ride with female drivers or riders for their trips. For Uber, this is a global first initiative. We don't have such a women-only product anywhere else in the world. We started with Bengaluru as it is the largest market for bike taxis. The city sees 5 million bike taxi trips across all the platforms per month, serving about 1 million riders and 1 lakh drivers, said Abhishek Padye, head of regional business operations, Uber India and South Asia, in an interview with Business Standard. Last mile transportation is in huge short supply in Bengaluru. What we realized is that 30% of our women riders were already taking bike taxis. With Uber Moto Women, we are not just offering a safer and more convenient ride option for women, but also empowering female drivers with the opportunity to earn flexibly in one of India's fastest growing mobility segments. The plan is to scale this up to other metro cities as well, Padye added. Bike taxis have rapidly emerged as one of the fastest growing transport options in urban India, according to a KPMG report titled Unlocking the Potential of Bike Taxis in India. Over 280 million bike taxi riders were completed across platforms in 2022. Bengaluru alone recorded over 1 million rides monthly, making it one of the country's largest bike taxi markets. Additionally, 65-70% of bike taxi trips cater to first and last mile connectivity, highlighting their importance in complementing public transport. Uber competes with players such as Rapido, Ola, and Nammayatri. It has introduced the Uber Moto Women service at a time when there are regulatory hurdles for mobility players in Karnataka, as the government has challenged the legality of bike taxis. According to the Karnataka Motor Vehicle Rules, two-wheelers with white number plates can't run commercial operations. In November, the Karnataka Transport Department cracked down on bike taxis associated with Uber in Bengaluru, arguing that the rules do not allow two-wheeler cabs. Experts noted that bike taxis are operating in Bengaluru under the protection of a High Court stay order. All the aggregators are actually collectively and very constructively engaging with the regulators to figure out what's the right regulatory framework, said Padye. About 1 million riders and 1 lakh drivers, 1 lakh drivers are using bike taxis, which is a testimony to the genuine need present in the market, and we are engaging with the government for this. Women's safety. Uber Moto Women harness the company's advanced technology-led safety features to provide a safer ride each time. Riders can share their trip details with up to 5 trusted contacts for real-time tracking, while anonymization of phone numbers and a drop-off addresses protects user privacy. റൈഡ് ചെക്ക്, ഊബേഴ്സ് പ്രോആക്റ്റീവ് സേഫ്റ്റി ഫീച്ചർ, മോണിറ്റേഴ്സ് ഇറഗുലാരിറ്റീസ് ലൈക്ക് ലോങ് സ്റ്റോപ്സ്, മിഡ് വേ ഡ്രോപ്സ് ഓർ റൂട്ട് ഡീവിയേഷൻസ് ആൻഡ് അതർ, ആൻഡ് ഓഫേഴ്സ് സപ്പോർട്ട് വെൻ നീഡഡ്. വുമൺ റൈഡേഴ്സ് ആൻഡ് ഡ്രൈവേഴ്സ് ഓൾസോ ഹാവ് ആക്സസ് ടു ഊബേഴ്സ് 24/7 സേഫ്റ്റി ഹെൽപ്പ് ലൈൻ വിച്ച് പ്രൊവൈഡ്സ് പ്രയോറിറ്റി സപ്പോർട്ട് ഫോർ വുമൻ വെൻ ദേ നീഡ് ഇറ്റ്. ലൈവ്ലിഹുഡ്. As per the KPMG report, bike taxis have the potential to generate up to 5.4 million livelihood opportunities in India. With female participation in the ride-hailing space in India continuing to be low, Uber Moto Women can encourage more women to drive. Flexible working hours, short distance trips and easy navigation will make it easier for more women drivers to drive on the platform. Offering complete flexibility, Uber Moto Women drivers also have the choice to turn off the option to accept female-only riders and accept all rides when they want. Similarly, the company said ride-hailing options like Moto Women can positively impact women's workforce participation. As per a study by Oxford Economics titled Ride-Hailing, A platform for women's economic participation in India, women's workforce participation could increase by over 6% by 2028 with greater access to ride-hailing options. The report also found that 75% of women choose ride-hailing for safer commuting compared to alternatives, while almost 1 in 3 women in India use bike taxis at least once a month. Thank you for listening. Thank you for watching. Thank you, everyone. Bye.